Most investors get caught up with just single family, small multifamily, but for you to make that jump into large multifamily and mobile home parks and to do it so fast, to a lot of people, that's just like, it seems so far out there. So maybe you can touch on that part. How were you able to do it?
What I want to really highlight is thinking about it differently, just reframe. So many people are held back by the way they think about things and their mindset. I think that's where one of my maybe advantages were. I didn't really see it as a big jump from going from residential to commercial. It's just a different route to financial freedom. That's all it is. The biggest myth that I want to dispel is like, you must have all this experience in real estate before you could even consider investing in large commercial deal, like an apartment complex, mobile home park, RV park. And you don't need to have all kinds of money in order to do it because you raise the capital through friends and family and accredited investors and non-accredited investors that are looking to park money. Like you, you're a limited partner. You are looking to park money in these deals. You don't need to be a mathematician in order to learn how to analyze the deals. You're just learning a different approach. Instead of owning 100% of a small residential property, you're owning a smaller percentage of a very large commercial property that's more scalable with more doors. A lot of pivotal moments for me were due to reading certain books. I read the book, The ABCs to Real Estate Investing by Ken McElroy, and that's what got my gear spinning. So I learned the process enough to like fuel my impatience. Like, I don't want to do one deal at a time and manage these single families. And that's not a bad way to go about it. You could testify to that. But I was really attracted to the art of A, I don't want to do everything myself. And for commercial multifamily, you're part of a team.
Let's talk about a mobile home park. The idea of just owning the land and someone paying you a lot rent versus having to deal with toilets and everything else that comes with residential real estate. I do like the idea of, hey, if something goes wrong on the property itself, it's the tenant's responsibility, not mine. Maybe you can speak on that because I know you have experience with that.
When we buy parks, there's going to be a mix of tenant-owned homes and park-owned homes. You don't want to own any of the homes. If you, let's say, buy a park where 50% of them are tenant-owned homes and the 50% are park-owned homes, there's always a process to convert those park-owned homes to tenant-owned homes. One of the best ways to do it is you literally are gifting that unit to the tenant for like a dollar and you're raising the lot rent up to market rent. You're essentially adding value. The more tenant-owned homes you have on the property and the higher your lot rent is and closer it is to market rent, that's what improves your net operating income, which improves the value.